Pitt powers with 6'6", Brian Shorter, one of the nation's strongest players. Shorter and the Panthers take on Seton Hall on Big Monday next. Hello once again, everyone, and welcome to ESPN's NCAA Basketball. I'm John Saunders, and join us for Big Monday, week number 5. We'll start it as usual in the Big East with Seton Hall and Pittsburgh. Both teams have lost a couple in a row. Pitt actually has lost 3 games in a row, but Seton Hall's just 3 off the lead. Northwestern and Illinois from the Big Ten. That will be our game at 9:30 Eastern time. Then we'll come back at midnight. It won't be from the Big West. It will be a non-conference game. Loyola Marymount takes on UC Santa Barbara. Joining me now, Jim Valvano, as usual here on Monday. Pitt, they have a tremendous guy, and we highlighted him in the opening of the show, and Brian Shorter. Now, how do you stop him?
Well, John, as you said, both clubs are coming off losses. Pittsburgh, though, got pounded. They didn't just lose out at UCLA. UCLA did a lot of good things. What they did very well was they played inside defense. Brian Shorter is a terrific power player for Pitt. But just look at this defense right here. You talk about a sandwich. Don McLean right here. Keith Owens right there. And there is the guy in the middle who they're trying to get the ball to. You can't do it. They couldn't do it. And UCLA had a great basketball game. And I think Seton Hall, coming off some tough games, trying to get it together. But they've got 4 straight road games. This is the 3rd of 4th on a row. And it's tough to get it going on the road. So they're going to have to do a job inside.
Seton Hall has a guy by the name of Anthony Avent, who some feel may be one of the best big men. Of course, you have to look at the guys at Georgetown, but maybe one of the best in the Big East. How do you stop him?
Well, it's the same thing. You know, as you get to the season, as it goes along, things start to become similar. And one thing everybody does is double down on the big guy. Get it outside. If you don't hit the outside shot, you're in for a good night defensively.
In other words, we should look for a lot of pounding in the paint in this one tonight. All right, stay with us. That one comes your way in just a moment. Pitt and Seton Hall at halftime. Jim Valvano's Court Concepts. We will once again try and teach you the game. Seton Hall and Pittsburgh coming up next. Stay with us.
It feels good to know what I want to do in life.
We're all here for the same reason, to succeed.
It's giving me a chance to start my own business and be my own boss.
I feel more confident going on to college.
I'm going to reach my goals a lot sooner.
It pays off.
Healthy Tech Center. The power to succeed.
So does your bank give you their best rate? Northstar does, with a Northstar One account.
The best rates? I deserve it.
And does your bank put all your accounts on one monthly statement? Northstar does. You get one with a Northstar One account.
One statement with everything? I like that.
Welcome to the Pitt training room. Come on in. You know, both coaches have asked me in for a mid-season analysis and evaluation. This will be a pain-free consultation. No cure-alls or instant mobility. And unlike some of my doctor friends, this one will be free of charge. You know, all year long, Pitt was expected to rank right on top in the basketball polls. But they've been struggling because they've had a number of maladies. Darrell Porter has played in pain all year long, but the real problem for Paul Evans, early in the year, Brian Shorter was not healthy, trying to find time for him and get him back to form. And Bobby Martin, of late, with the finger problem, not himself, just finding his true season form. Seton Hall has had more than enough of its share of misery this year. Let's take a look at one of my old centers who ran too many wind sprints when he played for me, and take a look at the injury problems of P.J. Carlesimo. If it wasn't the wrist, fingers, knee, leg, or ankle, well, at least they have meat on their bones. The training staffs of each university have used every piece of equipment imaginable. But the ultrasound to each coach's ears is the doctor's prescription, cleared to play. Let's keep the injuries in remission. Fellas, the Big East is up for grabs. Basketball happens to be a game of the mind and, of course, the heart. I believe, even though I'm not a cardiologist, both clubs have massive tickers.
This is a long way from downtown Chicago. Riding mass transit, working late every night. You finally got the raise that got you the gold card, that got you the phone number, that arranges your weekends wherever you want them. But you always want them in Montana. The gold card, only from American Express. Don't leave home without it.
160 horses. That's what Chevy S10 packs into the biggest V6 engine ever put in a compact pickup. Enough power to help switch more truck owners to Chevy last year than to any other truck. The move to Chevy is becoming a stampede. More people are winning with
America.
Now it's easy to win with the heartbeat.
Nothing beats it.
Nothing beats it.
The one and only.
Nothing beats it.
The clean, the crisp, the cold. The king of beers.
Nothing beats the Bud. Nothing beats the king of beers. Nothing beats a Budweiser. Nothing beats a Bud.
In today's higher revving and hotter running engines, wear is a greater problem than ever before. Oil breakdown can shorten the life of vital engine parts. That's why there's Castrol. Castrol provides maximum protection against viscosity and thermal breakdown. So use Castrol, because driving today can be a grind. Castrol, engineered for today's smaller cars.
ESPN's presentation of NCAA basketball. Seton Hall versus Pittsburgh is brought to you by Chevy Trucks. More people are winning with the heartbeat of America. And by Budweiser, the king of beers. With that clean, crisp, cold taste, nothing beats a Bud.
Mike Gorman, Bill Raftery back out here at the Fitzgerald Fieldhouse in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, a building that Pitt hasn't seen in about 5 weeks. Let's take a look at the starting lineups for tonight. For the Seton Hall Pirates, Anthony Avent trying to do this year what Mark Bryant did 3 years ago, carry the team.
For this to be a big event for Anthony, he's got to play naughty and touch it more than once or twice.
Ahmad Sharif, the new name in the Pitt starting lineup, but a healthy Brian Shorter, the key.
Michael, it's simple. To make it a shorter night, make sure Brian gets it way down tight.
Welcome back once again, everyone. I'm Mike Roman, along with the doctor here. And a big game for both of these teams. As we look at the Big East standings, you'll see why. Nobody really wants to get out of touch there with those three losses up top.
I just think that there's really very little respect for one another. The opponent coming into any building at a disadvantage, as Seton Hall is coming in here. But Pitt struggled at UCLA. So, that, by the way, you look fine, but take a couple aspirins and rest.
I'll do that. Brian Shorter looking fine of late. Anthony Avent having a strong season for the Pirates of Seton Hall. You know, they once said, Bill, when Dave Gavitt founded this conference, that his goal was that everyone would be 8-8.
Mm-hmm.
This is as close as it's ever come. B.J. Carlissimo, Paul Evans. And we're set to go. Tim Burris, Steve Corbin, and Mickey Crowley, the officials. We are underway. And Miller will bring it up. And the Pirates will be
traditional minimum.
Martin kicks it out to Sharif, who's covered by De Gea. Taylor's over on Miller. Porter looking inside. Avan's got shorter. That's a premier matchup in this league.
Pitt always in a triangle.
Here's Sharif handling the first time. A lot of pressure on the freshman getting the start. The pass picked off underneath, but the Pirates couldn't control it.
They'll either have a man on both box in the foul line, or they'll have a man on the box, the foul line in the corner. So it's a triangle situation, looking for multiple dump downs.
Pitt fans here at Fitzgerald stay on their feet. Sharif can't answer the call. Rebound by Winchester went up over Martin. Oliver Taylor ahead to Avan, who beat his man down the floor. Can't get it down, though. Kanishevich keeps it alive, and Miller, good hustle play.
That's what Pitt needs more of, Mike. If anything, when you're coming off the deck, and I have been there on occasion, you're just looking for a little enthusiasm, a little vim and vigor from anybody. That time, Miller.
The Hall will get it on the alternating possession. DeHaer, first shot. He's got two.
Good balance by the Hall.
Miller right back inside. Shorter unable to get the pass. Mickey Crowley's got the foul. Looks like Avent's got
Anthony
first.
Had the grab, Mike. Of course, caused the ball to go out of bounds. P.J. Carlissimo, an outstanding man-to-man defensive coach. They take pride in disturbing what you're trying to run, and they're very good at it.
Tough to say in a league that includes Georgetown. They're shorter down low. No, and Timmy Burke got a foul before the shot. Gordon Winchester's going to get that one.
Anything down there, they're going to jam in. The closest man to the player on the box will help out and double for Seton Hall.
Just to finish the thought, though, I'm not sure anyone in the league plays man better than Seton Hall.
No. Louis may take umbrage at that at 500.
I'll see him tomorrow. I'll see if he says it.
They got a piece. Wow. Jimmy Bird. I haven't seen that in quite a while, huh?
Showing it all, right?
Well, just checking the pee and the whistle. Refs like to get in the game, too. Now, this is not a total all-out press. Paul Evans does not have total commitment to the press.
Kanishev is handling it outside. That's Winchester. DeHaer finds Kanishev, knocked away by Porter. Avent, three pumps, can't get it down. Here comes Darrell Porter.
Anthony chose the incorrect side.
Back out to Miller. Pitt yet to get on the board. Shorter. Put two.
Regardless of size, he has great ability to curl.
Oliver Taylor, quick push, and Anthony Avent, the easy bucket.
Now Pitt showing signs of not balancing the floor, not recognizing and hustling back. You've got to see it. You've got to want to get back.
Porter for three. Avent there for the board. Quickly to Taylor. Up ahead, Winchester beats his man down the floor.
Well, that's generally a telltale sign you're in trouble.
Little jet lag here.
Well, giving up the easy ones. Too many peanuts, huh? Fortunately, they're in this building for a comeback. One of the loudest and toughest.
Sharif getting the chance, and he knocks one down.
Dribble drive, little play for Miller. Always looks to dish.
Ahmad once with the three. Avan once again, but this time Bobby Martin got a hand on it.
I think I'd like to see what Seton Hall's running. And so would Paul Evans as he chastises Bobby Martin.
Who argued back. Blocked by Kanishevich out of bounds.
There's a little sign in talking to different people of some discord and disagreement amongst players, and they're not balancing the floor. Paul Evans a little irate. We mentioned on our insert, the Sports Center, about the elder statesman not getting the minutes they desire, and all really trying to get everybody in touch for Big East and NCAA play.
Ryan Shorter to the bench, 2 minutes, 55 seconds into the game. Darren Morningstar in, 6'5", the Hall.
This dialogue is not bad. I mean, a lot of people get upset. Think of Al McGuire. If he didn't have a fight with his players, they went for a long night. He won an NCAA title as Bobby Martin didn't give the space.
And you will see a lot of dialogue on the sidelines between P.J. Carlissimo and his players. I mean, a lot of dialogue.
Healthy. It's expanding the lines, and in his case, trying to let them understand some English.
Daher comes up shooting. Sharif got a piece of it. Porter saves it nicely to Sharif. Two-on-two break here. Ahmad, the spin. Got the turnaround jumper.
And taking advantage of the early minutes.
A quick five for Sharif in Pitt's first lead. Nearly a five-second call. Taylor now resets the offense.
They like the shuffle cut off of it, then screen down. Reverse the ball to the postman. That's their traditional set. And what they do well, Mike, is they dip in and then seal their man so they can get some post action.
Darrell Porter, probably the quickest defensive hands on the Pitt team. Nice move by Daher. Leans in. Can't get it down. Martin the rebound. Miller with the head up.
I like to get Porter wide on occasion on their fast break.
Martin hits the jump shot.
Using that secondary break, huh?
Pitt
or just
three.
Or is that just getting down late?
I think that was a little of a lap.
Five.
Oh, the Taylor's got close a couple of times.
Yeah, he's been solid. 64 and 38 assist to turnover ratio. Pretty sound.
Hits that fading shot as well as anyone, too. Four different Pirates have scored. It's 9-8 Pitt. Sharif with five of the nine for Pittsburgh.
Martin really a perimeter player, not a great low post player. Vinicius has to stay at home. We're doing a little back cut for Martin.
Morningstar up top.
Talking to Darren about his dad, Gary. Nice little low post play.
Rebound, Karnishevich.
Saying how much he enjoys watching the game. Get a chance to see long distance from Washington with some play.
The hair, strong move on the baseline.
Darren also asked us not to say that he fouls at the breakfast table.
So we won't. Huh? 14:40 to go here first half. Martin puts a shoulder in a condition as he drills the jump shot.
Now you'd rather that shot than a penetration. Now Morningstar likes to be physical. A-Bank can do some damage if they take the time. He just had to reverse the guy, spin out on him. Get the thing down, see if they save it for Anthony.
Avent, that line drive hook shot of his won't go. Offensive foul, might be Winchester. It is. Gordon Winchester picks up his second, and we're going to get a timeout. 14:08 to go here first half. Walker will check in for the Pirates. Pittsburgh by one.
Flying from the top of the key is easy. It's the landings that kill your feet. That's why I fly with the pump from Reebok. When I pump up, my size 13s get support, protection, and a custom fit. So, Michael, my man, if you want to fly first class, pump up and air out.
Switch to the greatest sports performance shoe in the world, the Reebok Pump. Pump up and air out.
160 horses. That's what Chevy S10 packs into the biggest V6 engine ever put in a compact pickup. Enough power to help switch more truck owners to Chevy last year than to any other truck. The move to Chevy is becoming a stampede. More people are winning with.
The heartbeat of America.
Now it's easy to win with the heartbeat.
There's a new kind of cowboy out there, and that's why McDonald's is grilling up a whole new kind of steak. McDonald's new grilled steak sandwich. And right now, it's a great McDonald's value you can't pass up.
Imagine a rent-a-car company that delivers a car right to your door and drops you home when you return. That's Enterprise.
Here, let me help you.
Enterprise, a special rent-a-car company that gives you special delivery.
11-10, Pittsburgh by one. Even though we may escape for a couple of hours, all our minds are on the Persian Gulf, and Seton Hall has two players who have worries all over the world.
Well, obviously, it's been very difficult for both Archeris and Asaf, especially. Asaf's brother lives in Haifa. He follows the news on CNN just about every day and reads the newspapers. He's in touch, and his parents who live in Jersey are in touch with the family over there. And so he's got more than a passing interest, and so far he's been lucky and a little difficult for him to concentrate. Archeris, lately at least, the situation in Vilnius has cleared up a little bit, but I know when he was finally able to get through to his mother was counting the tanks out on the street, and he's obviously very disturbed about what's going on there, and he's got all kinds of family and relatives there. He told him that Vilnius has changed an awful lot, so I think for both of them, it's kind of difficult to forget about what's going on around the world and concentrate on basketball, but they're doing a reasonably good job.
The thoughts of P.J. Carlissimo on two of his players. Kanishevich is one handling the ball. He's the young man from Vilnius. Asaf Bonaire on the bench right now. Terry DeHaer gets two more. He's got six, and the Hall grabs the lead back.
A little more offensive-minded backcourt right now.
Short a double pump, can't get it in there. Loose underneath Winchester with Brian Caver in the game, playing with a bruise to his thigh, but he's got, looks like a football pad on it right now.
I thought that's probably a break. He'll slow down, keep PJ happy, but he's a fine-looking prospect. We got the little reach in.
Darrell Porter picking up his first.
I spoke to Asaf today at the shoot-around and said that he's gone from watching the news all day long to being a little bit more relaxed and relying on phone calls. Not a good play here.
Seton Hall turns it over. And of course, Arturis Kanishevich from Vilnius. Very concerned that, of course, they haven't had a chance to get to know both these kids during this, and it's amazing how they have held up. Miller with a little pull-up jump shot, won't go down. And Kanishevich with a big rebound.
Pretty sound, speaking of Kanishevich, and those that check out little things. The Americanization of the world.
They really shoot the three, too. Mm-hmm. DeHaer looking to penetrate again. Walker first time, can't get it down. Kanishevich goes and gets it, gets stripped out of bounds. The Hall will keep it leading by one with 12:42 to go here in the first half.
Michael, Sean Miller, very active, took the shot in this end. He's swiping on the floor early. They need somebody to stir up this talented group.
Brian Shorter, from the look in his face, picked up the foul.
Well, Brian knows what he's committed during the course of his career and not been called.
Avent in and Kanishevich out. Avent inbound. Avent couldn't control it. Porter picks it off. Miller the other way. Brian Caver's time on the court will be brief. And Oliver Taylor is back up at the scorer's table.
Turnovers. PJ does not care for them.
Martin to the hole, rejected by Avent. Out of bounds. DeHaer get the last hand on.
You notice they have two people on the box most sets, Pitt. And they've got options as how they want to get the basketball down there, depending on how you play them. It's very difficult to defend, particularly when the recipient of the pass can do some damage. Are you checking out to see all benches? I mean, if there's a little dialogue.
I was looking to see whether there's some dialogue down there as Terry DeHaer picks up a foul. PJ kind of followed Brian Caver down to his seat. Didn't have too much to say.
He brings these kids along, though. I mean, I've admired him a great deal as he's taught them his game. And what you do out of high school is you come in with your game, and it has to be refined. And just an amazing turnaround. I don't get the phone calls I used to from him. It's obvious.
He runs as tough and as loud a practice as you will ever see. And yet, no matter what is what goes down in the practice, the kids are laughing and joking with him 10 minutes later.
Well, he does have a way with them, no question. Again, penetration.
That's what the doctor ordered right there.
Yeah, a little more of that. But they have to be creative, I think. Get a, run their sets, but then find some options.
Oliver Taylor can't hit the three. Rebound. Porter keeps it alive. Winchester goes to the floor, but Porter quicker. Finds Jason Matthews just in the game.
Now I'm rooting for Matthews to get going.
Little double pump job. No. Morningstar. Big follow for two.
Well, less the ridicule which we give him on the fouls. He has turned his game in a positive vein. Just a terrific performance in low and very aggressive.
Turnaround jump shot, Winchester on the baseline. His second basket.
I think Evans had a good trip, a good time in California, do you?
I don't think so. Bryant shorter than jump hook.
Well, you don't have to talk to John Wooden to get the ball to shorter, huh? You pick that up on your own. Darren does a good job, really. He puts the leg up nice and high in the back, tries to move the man out, try and be physical, and occasionally, because I think if he didn't get that hair cut, he may have gotten away with it.
Kava and Barnea will check back in for Seton Hall, but first we'll get a timeout. 11-11 to go in the half. Pitt by three.
The bigger than ever four-door Chevy S10 Blazer. Now America's best-loved sport utility vehicle gives you four doors and standard four-wheel anti-lock brakes. The bigger-than-ever, better-than-ever 1991 four-door S10 Blazer. Open one up and see why more people are winning this.
The heartbeat of America. Chevrolet.
Now it's easy to win with a heartbeat.
Is that a new dispatcher?
Dad, she was here the last time you checked up on me.
So those Rollins guys, they still trying to steal our drivers.
Well, I think I got that under control. My Penn Weber guy set up a 401k. It's a pension plan, so obviously the longer a driver stays...
That must be costing a bundle.
Well, it costs a lot less than constantly breaking in new men.
How does a stockbroker know that you've been having trouble keeping drivers?
He asked.
Does the world's most fun cartoon character in a hot new 16-bit game?
Genesis does.
Who does Disney animation as only a 16-bit video game can?
Genesis
does.
Genesis
does.
Genesis
does.
Genesis
does.
Genesis does.
Who gives you $30 cash back when you buy a new Sega Genesis system?
Genesis does.
Buy a Sega Genesis system now and get $30 cash back.
Well, the guy for this club, I think, in terms of points, is Brian Shorter. And you just can't get them easily. You need some help. And Sean Miller, I think, just a different personality from recent games where he's creating for others. And Brian, the beneficiary. And there's the difference, I think, so far this ball game.
You need one advantage.
People getting involved. PJ's trying to run the TV crew now. He's upset at the position of our handheld. Paul Evans,
relatively indifferent, but.
Well, PJ, everybody, it's amazing.
Having some final words with Timmy Grove. We've got Jim Grove.
Well, they get together in the summer at different functions. Friendly during the game.
What time did you play the morning,
Jimmy? I'll take the team bus. Always get them on your side. I never thought of that until I finished. Oh, they're getting rid of the handheld because there isn't a place to hide. And Mickey Crowley, who's had his share of camera time in his career.
All right, that's...
Now, Mike, there were many nights I wanted to get thrown out of a building because of the way we were playing. But it had to get into...
Not how they were shooting.
Yeah.
All right, coming up here, lots of basketball tonight. Northwestern at Illinois will come by at about 9:30. Bob Carpenter and Dick Vitale standing by with that one. And then late tonight, Barry Tompkins and Quinn Buckner will bring you Loyola Marymount and Cal Santa Barbara. A big Monday of basketball here on ESPN. All right, we have rearranged the cameras and we're ready to go. It's Walker, Taylor, Caver, Barnea, and Avent on the floor for Seton Hall. Miller, Matthews, Porter, Morningstar, and Shorter. Walker trying to pull his way in and he traveled.
Well, our cameraman, Al Friedman, had a little egg on his face. It wasn't his fault. They wanted him behind the scorer's table. Well, that's the last time I appear on Carlissimo's show. Can't treat our guys like that. Actually, it was the fans behind that felt they couldn't see. Is what we're told.
Pitt, the three-point lead and the ball. Miller a little daylight. Taylor's got him defensively by there. He's covering the quarter. He's got to push him up down blocks. Does it always end up in the shape of a triangle?
Good help there, Brian Tabor.
Now that's an unselfish pass, but not a good one. Sean has to get it down, get a better angle, and dump it down. As Shorter presents himself so well.
Terry DeHair will check back in, and Oliver Taylor sits down. That puts Caver at the point this evening.
They usually run bumps for Jason Matthews out of bounds.
Wow, nobody home on that pass. It's picked off by Caver after Shorter tried to save it. Caver, coast-to-coast job. Little pull-up off the glass.
Over two. Big lead. The pressure to bounce. And of course, that elevation quickly.
Darrell Porter, good up fake. Hits the leaner. Hit holding on to the three-point lead as we approach the halfway mark of the first half.
He's got to go back baseline.
Carnivorous for two.
You mentioned the three-pointer. That's something I haven't noticed. The jumper, usually good with that standstill push-out.
Ryan, little swing move and hits the hook again. His second of the night. He's got 8 points.
How about him away from traffic, too? Carnivorous over to help. Negated. Might be a five, yeah. He just bounced it, didn't reset, should have given it up and gotten it back.
All coming with a bit of pressure here. Miller shot a quick glance over to Paul Evans to call the play off the pit bench.
Pick and roll, and they slip that beautifully.
Morningstar gets the roll.
Real good job by Darren. Before the pick is established, he sees his man pop out, slides to the goal.
Pitt's biggest lead, five. Avent answers quickly.
Let him touch it.
Matthews trying to get on track, nearly threw it away, but Morningstar got the pass in the basket.
Well, you want support, and a lot of people might be upset with that being late, but you can't gamble and lead a guy to the basket.
Avent again down on the blocks, tries the fall away this time.
He switched it up. That's what he should have done earlier. The overplay was to the middle, obviously scouting.
Short of the spinning move, gets his own rebound, stripped and a foul. It'd be Carnivorous reaching in. It is, and it's the first on Arturas. Bobby Martin comes in for Pitt. Gordon Winchester comes back in for Seton Hall. Asaf Barnea will sit down, and Morningstar, who came in and got a quick six off the bench, sits down for Pittsburgh.
I've seen a lot of different leagues play, but there's more scraping on misses, flailing of arms in the Big East. I don't know whether it's the officials enjoy watching them go after one another, but there's a lot to let go as they attack that glass. You can have a lot of big people on the pines to exist.
Well, Pitt has the long bench this year, which last year was a complaint that they didn't have it. This year, the complaint is they use it too much.
They're not reacting to the ball. You can't win, can you?
Matthews misses his first shot, and Winchester is there.
Control break. Ball got some early ones, opportunity-wise.
Gaber finds the hair. Trying to create a shot on Matthews.
Steps.
Does. No. Travel. Good call.
They've been effective inside, but guards impatient. They want to do it themselves. Play within it. 1-3-1 look. Now, this is the defense that he brought in the first game to Seton Hall. One ended up an easy one. No close. That's an unusual type of pass. It's usually the other angle, the other box that's free.
10 for Brian Shorter, 5 to Pittsburgh lead. Avent calling for it down on the block. Winchester instead the pull-up. Very short. Porter is there. Behind the back to get by Winchester. Finds Matthews. Darrell, the leaner.
Pretty good poise. Perimeter passing. And Seton Hall calls the time.
7-point Pittsburgh lead, and PJ calls the time 29-22.
So you've been with your bank, what, 5, 10 years? They ever do anything special for you?
Please.
North Star does, with a North Star One account.
Now that renews my faith in banks. Well, one.
And does your bank give you a personal banker?
A personal banker?
North Star does. You get one with a North Star One account.
A personal banker?
Moi?
It's time to get a cellular phone, but where do you go?
When everybody wants to sell you one. Hardware store, discount store, car stereo store. It's a cellular jungle out there.
Better come to a 9X Cellular Center. Our professionals will set you straight with answers on cellular communications and our selection of quality portable and installed phones. The reassuring fact is, for mobile communications, the answer is 9X.
ESPN, the leader in sports programming, has captured 7 ACE Awards. Cable television's highest honor. To all ACE Award winners throughout the cable television industry, congratulations from ESPN, the Total Sports Network.
Darrell Porter, you think of Don Nelson and the point forward, Paul Pressey, Chris Mullin, of course, Bill Bradley back from your era, a lot older than me, able to handle the basketball, and then the perimeter passing coming back to him. Some addition to your offense when you can have your third guy who led the team in assists last year when Miller was out, run the show when necessary.
Miller out on Taylor. Matthews jumps out on DeHair. They go to Haven again, and there are the quick hands of Darrell Porter.
Some disadvantage for him, too. He was dead with Big Anthony looming.
7:14 to play here, first half. Pitt the 7-point lead, the biggest of the half. DeHair can't hit the three, and Martin, good position on Avak.
Quick shot, little screen, didn't try.
Martin, the trailer on the break, doesn't get that one down, and Porter there for the rebound amongst a lot of blue shirts.
Right now, a little hungrier for white shirts.
Martin stuffed by Winchester, and a jump ball is called. It'll still go Pitt's way. Great defensive play.
Nice reaction. As Gordon played pretty well against Malik Sealy a couple of weeks ago. Of course, you don't control Malik forever.
He's pretty well against him in the Garden the other day, though, too.
First half, I guess, right?
Yeah.
Good staggered screen for Jason.
Shorter, long with it. Martin, the weak side rebound. Looks for some room. Kanishevich the block. Loose ball. Taylor and Miller dive for it. Porter spins out of there. Darrell, great no-look pass, but it was too hard.
Ooh, was it?
Ryan Shorter.
Ryan Doran at his best. Harsh delivery, but isn't that gorgeous when you see a ball after?
All trying to cut into this lead. Kanishevich pops out, looking for Avent. They had him over the top that time.
And box to box with him, a little screen away for him.
Moves on Martin.
Got a ton of them.
That's why they're going to him.
Got that little jump hook too, little turnaround, mixing it up.
8 for Anthony Avent, 5 the lead. Pitt has it on the ball.
Timo just took them out of what they wanted to run that time.
Shorter, partially blocked, but there's the foul. Avent has picked up his second.
Anthony really stuck as they make a nice entry pass baseline, but Timo took away the pick and roll high, forced it the other way.
Antoine Jones will check in. Darrell Porter goes out.
Just the strength, the left arm able to hold, and Anthony Hughes didn't hustle to regain that baseline. As the ball is thrown, you have to make the judgment. I can't get there. Get in position. Get some help from top, from up top.
The 11 first half points now for Brown.
And BJ referred to his hands as knee hooks. The meeting with our production crowd.
Look at those.
Lead back to seven.
Doesn't drop too many, does he?
No, he does. He did earlier, though, when he was weakened. There's Avent getting free for two more.
What Pitt has done is not let the ball be reversed to that top guy. Jones just then fell asleep. Nice movement and call.
Jones pops out. Traveled with it.
Now, there's a case of not understanding what's going on. Porter is getting his way down low, and you're looking for a jump shot. Just work, let him go. You may get Anthony Avent number three.
The Hall a chance to get to three. The hair pops out. Nice look for Avent.
They got a walk here on the slide. Oh.
Good call.
That little slide step, but good penetration, much better play by De Hare. Something about De Hare, a live figure on the floor. Presents problems defensively for people. Range and the ability to bounce.
Martin looking low for Shorter.
Always that triangle. Both boxes and high posts. At some point in the set. Double for Jason.
Picked off this time by Taylor. Pitt has no numbers here, or Seton Hall rather didn't have any. De Hare forced one up and got it.
Incidentally, I don't think Taylor was counting properly. Either that or he needs a new bat class. Forcing the issue. That's what De Hare can do, make the tough basket.
The 7-point lead down to three.
Back screen, the power game.
Over the top, out of bounds, and Pitt will keep it. And Sharif comes back in along with Darrell Porter.
Anthony not asleep out there, though. He had been playing the top side out towards the half court line. That time switched, almost came up with a steal.
Matthews and Miller go to the bench. Darrell Porter now and Ahmad Sharif, the backcourt for Pitt. Very quick. Avent gambled and lost.
On the out of bounds, not set in the stance, in position. Good read by Pitt.
14 for Brian Short. Over the top, Avent couldn't control the pass.
That's got to be led to the corner of the basket, not back over a guy's head. And really, Vardishevis, a better guy to dump it down, Mike.
4 minutes straight up to go in the half, and Pitt leads by five.
Why does a man have to do what a man has to do?
Two, three, four.
Try Bud Dry. Cold filtered for smooth draft taste. Dry brewed for no aftertaste. Refreshing proof that men still know what they're doing.
The day you bring home your first new car is like no other day. And the first car more people bring home is Chevy Cavalier. That's why more people are winning with
the heartbeat of America.
And now it's easy to win with an efficient new Cavalier.
To go that extra mile takes a healthy diet rich in protein. General Nutrition Center's Pro Performance Amino 1000 is the scientifically developed protein supplement. Amino 1000 can help give you the edge. To max your workout, you should be in great shape and can supplement your diet with Amino 1000's gel capsule designed for fast absorption. Amino 1000, exclusively at GNC, the authority in sports nutrition.
Back to Mike and Bill in a moment, but here's a look at this score. East Tennessee State ranked number 13, a 20-point lead. They led by 18 at halftime. Their only loss was to Tennessee Chattanooga in the conference. At halftime, Jim Valvano's Court Concepts. Get back to the game.
All right, John, thanks very much. 33-28, Paul Evans' club with a 5-point lead. 4 minutes straight up to go in the first half. Seton Hall coming with full court pressure.
And
the free safety in the hair.
Jones getting right back to quarter up to Sharif. Started the game very quickly, then went to the bench for an extended period of time.
Darrell, the point guy right now. The power game, double box.
Martin swallowed up, picked off underneath by Winchester.
Oh. Gotta go up with it.
DJ Carlissimo got Oliver Taylor's attention in case he had any ideas of taking that one to the hole.
That's the pet center just running the screen down.
The hair hits a three.
So much for the screen down.
I was just gonna say.
Walker down on the box, pretty good low post player, plays bigger than his size.
11 for Terry DeHaer in the half.
Good match for shorter, too, physically. Even though Evan gets a rest.
Jones comes up shooting.
That'll help loosen it up inside.
Karnishevis will try. Back rims the three. Sharif. Better watch out. And Walker runs over.
Now that's unusual, Jerry.
Ahmad was fortunate there.
Yeah, that didn't go all the way on top, but not able to sidestep. Christmas had problems with the wrist, but others. Sam's jacket. Because this game will keep it there.
Hard to believe that
he eats, huh?
Jerry Walker could sneak up.
We're just a feed alone. But finishing that PJ, the way he eats and the time he eats, it's amazing. He keeps that spelled look.
Six for the freshman.
Walker defensively inside, well tutored in high school. Bobby Hurley at St. Anthony's year in and year out turns out great players. But sound that he should do well while Anthony is resting for Seton Hall. Up and down.
Wow. Those turnovers are killing the Hall here in the half. Caver will come right in and Oliver Taylor will go out. Basketball coming up all week long here on ESPN. Tuesday night, Oklahoma takes on Kansas State at 7:30. And then at 9:30, it'll be the Shack against the Threes as LSU and Kentucky.
And see if Dale gets upset over anything.
Antoine Jones unable to put it down. Rebound to Avon.
And speaking of Oklahoma, Tommy Tubbs here scouting Seton Hall. They have a game Saturday.
Sounds just like his dad. Great bounce pass. And Winchester couldn't get it down. Avent goes and gets it. No call. Goes up again and banks it home.
That's that little jump hook. He delivers so beautifully.
A dozen for Avent.
They need some activity like that on the glass. They've not been rebounding at either end.
Avent and DeHaer with 23 of the 33. Over the top, Bobby lost the handle.
Bobby just pointing to himself. You got to squeeze it. He's tired. Bobby with the finger problems and never has, at least in my mind, regained that ability he showed a couple of years ago.
Now, do you want to go right to Avent? You see a guy pointing to himself
sure,
as he runs out.
See if Seton Hall's patient enough to reverse it for the dip in. There it is. They are.
They got it.
Coaching. Not by me. I would have my guys lining up a three.
14 now for Avent.
That's the difference with this club. They know exactly what he wants.
36-35 Pitt.
Go curl.
Jones forced one up and got the roll.
Got to get that dribble. Guy's got to react from the top.
Done a pretty good job of taking this building out of the game so far. This usually is a very, very loud place.
The numbers are high, and there's a lot of hurry to make their mark. Same little play. This should be for Abbott if they can relax and wait.
DeHaer. He got it up there somehow.
Well, skinny guys can amaze you with their strength. But he can keep the big guy happy by back dribbling or fan dribbling and dumping down.
Sharif picks up the foul and stick around at halftime. John and Jim will be by top 25 scores. And Valvano's court concepts will be on junk zone defenses.
Ooh, and he's thrown a few.
He could do a week on that.
But they won't have enough time. He'll get one principal in. But he could change clubs and their direction.
I think trick zone defense is the way we were supposed to promote. I'm sorry, Jim, by going to the junk zone.
Jimmy's had a few tricks in his days.
The Hall within two with 36 seconds to go in the half.
A little pressure after Mike.
I think.
Yeah, maybe make them shoot it quickly, force them into some silly mistake. That's what BJ does. They got a hold on Ryan. Gaver just not in position, and Miller asserting himself to the basketball.
That's the 18th foul on the Hall, so it's still 1-1. With Sean Miller at the 9, that's pretty much money in the bank. Avent comes back in, Barnea goes out.
At the foul line for Pitt.
Said his dad is 18-0. High school coach out this way. He started very young, bouncing that ball.
Sean wants to be a coach. He and Darrell Porter have coached a youth team here over the last three summers.
Quite successfully.
Yes, very well.
They took a team to Vegas a couple of summers ago.
First two for Sean Miller. And the Hall with the ball and a chance to get to one or tie with a three as we head for the half.
Here's the delay game. How late do you want to take it and who do you want to shoot? Invariably, the defense takes you out of it. They should maybe run a normal set, I'd say between 15 and 10, because it takes a while to get Anthony back down low.
You see Mickey Crowley extending his hands. That's the distance, he's saying. They have to be within that distance for him to start a count. The hair, another thought, a shot he didn't like.
Well, he weren't patient. Anthony should have kicked it and gone down and pinned.
Pittsburgh has a three-point lead here at the half, but you really wouldn't know it. And the reaction of the crowd here at Fitzgerald Fieldhouse, 40-37. Jim and John will be by after these words.
Every day that goes by, one of the highest mileage, lowest price, and the best-selling of all V6 coupes is Chevy Beretta. Day by day, more people are winning with
the heartbeat of America.
And now it's easy to win with the heartbeat.
For years, I never even thought about it. Guess I just didn't want to face things.
Yeah, I've been there.
But now, my parents, they need real help. It's gonna be tight. We'll just have to manage somehow.
I got this guy at Payne Weber. Put me in a mutual fund for my parents. Same time he set up my kid's college fund.
That long ago? How do you know about your parents back then?
He asked.
It was a dumb argument. It all started when she said she went to the GM dealership for an oil change. How long did it take, I asked? Less than 29 minutes, she said. Well, what, did they do anything else or just change the oil? She said they checked the fluids and everything. In less than 29 minutes, guaranteed. She said, no way, I said. Then she said, why don't you ever believe me? That's when I knew I was in trouble. Thanks.
Your GM dealer's serious about putting service back in the service department. So try Mr. Goodwrench Quick Lube Plus for a change.
ESPN's presentation of NCAA basketball, Seton Hall versus Pittsburgh, is brought to you by Payne Weber, serving the financial needs of individual, corporate, and institutional clients. And by Mr. Goodwrench and your participating GM dealer, keeping quality on the road.
Welcome back to first of three here on Big Monday. And we have a three-point game at halftime. Pitt has the lead over Seton Hall, 40-37. And Jim Valvano, we talked about Brian Shorter in the opening of the show. Seton Hall hasn't exactly got the job accomplished, although early they did stop.
That's right, John. Early on, Seton Hall did just what we tried to show you at the top of the show, and that is double down on people. Make it tough for Brian Shorter. Here you see Sean Miller makes the pass, and right there, you see Seton Hall has, look how many players coming to the basket. What Shorter should do here is make a pass back out. But unfortunately, he's a little bit hungry early, right? Not a good choice. They don't get the basket, and so they had some problems, John. But a good adjustment by the coaching staff, and what happened was they said, Sean Miller, drive. When he started to drive and he started to dish, it opened things up, and 14 points for Brian Shorter. Had a good inside game picked in.
14 for Brian Shorter, 14 for Anthony Avent. They have to find a way to stop him down at the box.
Well, I think that's exactly both clubs we mentioned. They're both powerful teams. And the game started out very, very physical, but the referees did stop it. And what you see are two clubs who run good half-court stuff, and they run very good offense. They're going to go inside first, but you still have to. I say it again. The ball's got to go back outside. Someone's got to start lighting it up from downtown. That's the club that'll win.
Both teams in need of a victory. Two losses in a row for Seton Hall. Three losses in a row for Pitt. Stay with us when we come back. We'll have a look at Jim's court concepts as we help teach the game, and this one should be a good one, so keep it right here as we go to break. Let's take a look at this week's top 25. There's no change at the top.
Cowboy out there, and that's why McDonald's is grilling up a whole new kind of steak. McDonald's new grilled steak sandwich. And right now, it's a great McDonald's value you can't pass up. Who guarantees overnight air delivery before 10:30 to the most people coast to coast? Who did you think?
Great defense starts with your feet. And I have MVP feet. That's why I plan to pump from Reebok. When I'm pumped up, I get support, protection, and a custom fit that's unbeatable.
I'm a hot dog, but when it comes to protection, this is no bull. Pump up and air out.
Switch to the greatest sports performance shoe in the world, the Reebok Pump. Pump up and air out.
Welcome back. Pitt leading Seton Hall 40-37. Time now for Jim Valvano's Court Concepts, where we study the game.
Yes,
you know,
yes.
The three-point arc has really changed basketball in the last few years, especially when you're going to run a zone.
No, John, I really feel that the three-point line is the biggest rule change we've had in college basketball, at least in my lifetime. And it just is, it changed dramatically on the defensive end. Why? Because all of us who used to like to play that zone, you can't do it now because a regular zone has too many opportunities for the bomb, and you'll get killed with three-pointers. You know what happens? A lot of coaches are resorting to trick defenses, right? I used to love to play these, and I used to love to teach them. John Chaney, all right, from Temple, loves to play zone. He's used to playing a straight zone. But here against Georgia Tech earlier in the year, John Chaney says, you know what? I can't give up three-point shots. Notice what a matchup zone is. The very first trick defense that people try to play, where you match up on the perimeter. You see, there are no openings here for three-point shots. All right, and so when the ball does move, the people move with it, and so therefore you try not to give up that three-point bomb. And I think it's been very effective. And so that's the first thing you try and do, John. You say, okay, we're going to match up. But now what happens when you have a team that's got that one superstar? Maybe you want to stop them on one possession. Well, Louisville and Denny Crum, who doesn't usually do this, against Memphis State and Elliott Perry. Look at it. You see the guy who's being checked, Elliott Perry right there? But what were they playing? Was it a straight man-to-man? That's what you might think. But no, on second look, it is one. There's one man. Three. One, two, three. And a chaser right here. Elliott Perry is being guarded man-to-man. All right, this is an attempt to not permit the star to get the basketball and contrives to love this defense, all right? Dean Smith was innovated just so much in the game of basketball, the four corners, all kinds of things. Well, even that man who very rarely ever changes defense to stop a particular player, well, try and stop two players. Triangle and two, all right? And here again against Georgia Tech, which is a club that gets a lot of this. Why? Because of this man over here, Kenny Anderson, who's being checked by King Rice, and this guy, Rick Barry's son, John Barry, is being checked by Davis right here. So what you have is two guys playing man-to-man, and there it is, the triangle. It's an isosceles triangle, I think, John. I'm not sure. But there's a hypotenuse. But we're going to give you a little bit lesson in everything here. But the triangle in two now tries to stop two players. And to be honest with you, these defenses have been very, very effective. They're hard to beat.
Court concepts is becoming geometry 101 very fast here. All right, so now we know how you try and stop it on the defensive end. How do you beat those zones?
All right, that's what's happening, right? Because you're seeing it more and more, so people have said, what do I do to beat it? Against the normal zone, you want generally ball movement. Players can be stationary, and you're looking for ball movement. Against a trick defense, right, you need first cutters, a lot of player movement. That's number one. If that doesn't work, since it's more matchup, go one-on-one. Kentucky earlier in the year did this very well against Notre Dame. Rick Pitino made a great adjustment. Right? If that doesn't work, what a lot of coaches do, and it can be effective, is number three is run your man-to-man offense. And that's what you'll see more and more, I think, because of the three-point shot. You're going to see these types of defenses, and coaches are going to have to adjust.
So now we know what you're going to do on the defensive end and the offensive end. We look for innovations. Anything new you've seen lately?
You're smiling, John, because you know on Big Monday we bring you all the innovations of the game. I saw a defense I didn't even recognize this weekend. I'm telling you, here is Pittsburgh playing UCLA, and look at the defense right here. Look at that defense. It's the diversionary shoeless zone. Derek Martin right there took his shoe off to confuse Sean Miller here. And let's see if this type of defense works. I've never seen that. Should he pick it up? Yeah, I think so. No, he fakes again. And now Sean Miller's got to, look at this, he could go in here, but does he? No, the diversionary shoe forces him to the outside, John. Pushes him out of three-point. There's the shot. Does it work? Of course it works. I haven't seen that one before, but the diversionary shoeless zone, it could be here to stay.
We just got a call from a shoe company. They've come out with a shoe now that guards without the player in it.
There it is.
So, I mean, apparently we have come up with a new innovation. Stay with us. There's more to come on Big Monday, as usual. The first of three, and we're in a three-point game. Back with more in a moment.
Many questions are being asked about hair loss. Mine were answered by this booklet. It's free, and it's put together by the Hair Replacement Centers. And to help you get it, they'll even give you this 800 number. Now, with this free call, you can find out why their non-surgical individual strand application works. Looking natural is something I depend on. So for me, the Hair Replacement Centers is the natural choice.
Call Hair Replacement Centers now for your free informative booklet. 1-800-453-3800.
So does your bank give you their best rate? Northstar does, with a Northstar One account.
The best rates? I deserve it.
And does your bank put all your accounts on one monthly statement? Northstar does. You get one with a Northstar One account.
One statement with everything? I like that.
Welcome back to Big Monday. A quick check of the scoreboard. Virginia facing Radford. They're up to number 11 and winning big 42-29 at halftime. Tennessee Chattanooga losing to East Tennessee State now 73-45. Mr. Jennings already with 14 in that game. Number 12, Southern Miss facing Appalachian State. And they have the lead 63-50, 13:30 to go in that game. All right, Jim, what do you look for in the second half?
We're at the part of the season, John, where it's more the same. You're not going to see guys change too much. You're at the part of the season where execution wins basketball games, both on the offense and the defense. We'll see who executes better in the second half.
Pitt has a three-point lead as we went to the locker room. The second half still to come in the first of three here on Big Monday. Stay with us. The second half comes up in just a moment.
never going to work.
Relax. Anybody can send them roses.
Excuse me, we didn't order these. Ian, what's this?
Hi!
Did they really expect us to call them?
I'm telling you.
Hello! Nothing beats a
bud! Meet my wife, Sue. Awesome tennis player, soccer coach, avid weekend gardener, executive, and all-around great mom. When we get hungry, there's one thing she'll drop everything for. Campbell's Chunky Soup. We love it. Chunky has delicious chunks of chicken and noodles, and best of all, it's quick to satisfy, so she can keep going without slowing down and take the kids to the movies. Hey, what about me?
Campbell's Chunky Soup, the satisfying stop that keeps you going.
Financial news. The full-size Ford pickup is not only priced less than Chevy when you buy it, an independent study shows it costs less to operate while you own it. And it's worth more when you sell it.
Ford trucks, the best ever.
From the moment you buy it to the moment you sell it, Ford puts Chevy in the red and you in the black. More people are driving the best-built, best-selling American trucks than ever before.
Basketball, Seton Hall versus Pittsburgh, is brought to you by Ford and your Ford dealer. Have you driven a Ford lately? And by Nike, who reminds you to just do it.
We are back here at the Fitzgerald Fieldhouse on the campus of the University of Pittsburgh, and the Panthers have themselves a three-point lead, 40-37. Mike Gorman, along with Phil Raftery, and off the top of the show, after your house call, we talked about Anthony Avent and Brian Shorter, and they have come through.
Well, in a basketball house, he's awfully tough to play. He's got good concepts offensively. Defensively, more importantly, he just knows how to play people. He's gotten a few fouls, but on occasion, the fronting, the three-quarter, right here, making sure the entry pass doesn't come. But then, the read opening up, blocking the shot, very alert. And, of course, on occasion, a deflection where the guards come down a little bit late to help out. And then the step in, the dip is fronted, and they throw that little loop pass to him, and he's had an impressive beginning. Just get it to him, Mike.
He is a man inside, 14-5-1, the numbers for Anthony Avent. And not to be outdone on the other side, Brian Shorter, who was the mainstay of this club last year, is starting to round back into that type of form again.
He really knows how to play some offense. When they get it to him, he has a read, a feel of what to do with the basketball. When it's a shape up in the three, which is an impossible, which side do I deny the basketball? How do I guard the man? Right there, if they got it right down, they got it a little bit late, he's still as affected. That time with the left, and he just understands what's going on. That drop step, the defense on the baseline drops strong, and finish to the goal.
14-2-1, the numbers for Brian Shorter. And as my mom always says, you be frank and I'll be earnest. I'll be frank here. If either team puts together about 5 minutes of intense basketball here, they can put this game away.
Jimmy Valvano, on occasion, has said various five-minute marks are important, this being one of them. And neither club has shown effective basketball for any length of time. And whoever steps up might turn the game.
Miller outside on Taylor as Pitt comes out man. Ford is on Karnishevas.
John Wood, this is his type of offense. There's the guy.
Even the jump hook goes down again.
Now Bobby Martin's got to use his strength, chuck him, push him out. But Seton Hall wisely out of the gate with the sure answer.
Jason Matthews getting the start in the second half after being scoreless in the first half. He was scoreless in the first half against UCLA on Saturday.
I almost feel like saying to Pitt, hey, get happy. The young guys, nice defense, should be a jump.
And it is Karnishevas with the block. Pitt will get it on the alternating possession, but a good defensive play by Arturis Karnishevas down low.
Things not going well for Pitt. Heads down on occasion. They're young. It's a shot at an awful lot of fun. Enjoy it.
Durrell Porter can't put down the three. Loose ball. Taylor out of the pack with it. Got help with the hair. Takes it himself and was fortunate to get a foul. Sean Miller will pick it up.
Are you saying fortunate because of the official or
fortunate
PJ?
He had no shot.
No, PJ was up almost trying to stop that one-man break.
Oliver Taylor, junior college transfer last year, who has really settled down in the point guard role this year.
Look at John Morton, too. I mean, first couple of years, I remember Dave Gavitt not enjoying John at all in his first couple of years in doing the TV games, and all of a sudden, John Morton understood what was asked and translated it beautifully into that final four appearance.
All looking for their first lead in a while, and they get it.
And the pressure trying to keep Miller at least away from the basketball. So others have to run.
Now they back it off. Oliver Taylor will be on Sean Miller as the crowd rather tries to get themselves in this game.
They can really get it to Port if they get the good angle to dump it down. Darrell has it.
Over the top, shorter, no. Avent the rebound.
Good luck. It's kind of shot you want.
Seton Hall with numbers, and Winchester missed the layup.
And those are always backbreakers, depending on what Pittsburgh does.
Durrell finds some room for two. That's a four-point swing right there. Pitt gets the lead back by one.
What happened to Winchester, his leg went out from under him. Just lay it up. Use that glass, caress, and kiss.
And that'll be Bobby Martin holding off on Anthony Avent. The third on Martin, who's the only player in any semblance of foul trouble. Six here in the Big East, so he's got a way to go.
Michael, not easy to defend a guy like Anthony, particularly when they empty out both boxes. He can roam, do whatever he wants. Big, strong, worked hard.
And he had the shorts.
Mm-hmm. To boot.
Darrell Porter picks up that foul, his second.
Forcing Vinicius to put it on the floor, played up and under him.
So three quick team fouls here on Pittsburgh in the first minute 51 of the second half. Even. Not this time. Winchester up big with shorter jump ball. This time Seton Hall again.
That's the kind of shot you'd love if you're PJ Carlissimo. And right now Pitt not finding a way to maneuver the big fella away from the box. Nice double on the out of bounds.
The hair, open jump shot, no. Rebound is shorter this time.
Can't ask for anything more, though. Within the offense, that's the way he has to play.
Darrell Porter. Oh, great pass from Matthews. Missed the easy one. It's all Hall on the rebound. Taylor out of the pack with it. Got the hair on a wing. Line. Goes the other way and banks it home.
Oh, my goodness. You get the feeling Oliver didn't like Terry. Send him a postcard. I guess all's well, huh? If it goes in.
If it goes in.
Give it up.
Matthews trying to get himself on track. Leans in. Hits one. First bucket for Jason Matthews comes with 17 minutes to go in the game.
Yeah, he struggled out in L.A., but you got all his family out there watching him, expecting him to have a big game, and they still are young people.
The hair found some room. No, says Mickey Crowley, stepped on the baseline.
Well, that was the old let the stewardess through move. Speaking of a long trip, Jason just opened up that baseline.
Haver comes in for the hair.
Sounds like Wilt is back there, huh?
Bad pass. Oliver Taylor picks it off over to Winchester. Reverse for two.
All right, that makes up only a half a dozen eggs on his brow.
We go back and forth on the odd number, the Hall by one.
Just screen down for Porter.
Into Martin. Forces it up. Gets the bounce and the foul.
Taylor very active over helping. Beautiful defensive play. But that's the type of play I thought he would do by his senior year continually. In traffic, people surrounding him. Slight but strong, finishing plays. And that would make Paul Evans smile a little bit on those coast-to-coast journeys.
Terry DeHaer just came up to you and tried to check in.
Well, I guess he's not familiar with the surroundings here.
Just thinks you got a piece of everything. Martin completes the old-fashioned three-point play.
Only a few guys that have that.
Strong to the hoop, Winchester too hard off the glass. Darrell Porter out and running with the rebound. Between the legs, finds Miller, plenty of time, got it.
And Bobby Martin got up big defensively to change that a little bit. Set up the explosion.
5-point Pittsburgh lead, 16-18 to go in the game. Winchester.
You gotta reverse it, then get him the other way.
Vinicius wants it on Darrell Porter. Oliver Taylor takes a runner and hits it.
And Darrell has all of Lithuania as he reaches around Karnishevas. Hold it on. And that opened up a little bit of the baseline.
Jerry Walker. Antoine Jones is going to check in for Pitt. And Jerry Walker comes in for Seton Hall. Winchester and Porter go out. Seton Hall comes with a full court pressure. Miller looking and finding Jones, he gives it right up.
Get it to Shorter. There's a little weave play they run.
Matthews dips the shoulder, nearly got stripped, and loops it back to Miller. That's a big time three he just took right there. Avent the rebound. Seton Hall again with numbers. Great play, Antoine Jones, but Jerry Walker stole it right back.
Now that was a great look cross court, but a better defensive play. You're right, Mike. Gotta pay attention now. It's not over. An easy takeaway.
Condition is putting it on the floor. Leans in, got contact, no call. Out of bounds, saved by Avent, but he stepped on the baseline.
Karnishevas treated like an outsider on that play. They got a lot of him.
They sure did. 15-13 to go in the game. Hit by three. PJ unhappy.
Gerald Wilkins and Super Dave Osborne to compare the Nike Air Flight Lite with the Super Dave Slam Dunk Catapult.
Good luck, Harold.
That's Gerald.
Mm-hmm. Now, this whole thing is covered with genuine Saskatchewan salmon skin for real safety.
Mm. The Air Flight Lite is the lightest Nike basketball shoe on earth.
Excuse me, mine's got Kelman circuitry.
It's been patented, so don't try to knock it off.
This is the lightest Nike basketball shoe on earth.
Let's check it out. I mean,
this beauty's gonna stop halfway and then launch me 37 feet in the air. Here we go. We're stopping.
No, we're not.
Yes. I think I broke my face.
Well, of course you did.
Help me.
You decide, the lightest Nike basketball shoe on earth or a broken face.
Help me, Harold.
That's Gerald.
Oh, that hurt.
Great games coming up here on ESPN. Some great players. Shaquille O'Neal, Eric Murdoch of Providence, Mutombo in mourning for Georgetown. We've got a three-pointer right here. And Jim Burr got an earful. DJ Collison during that break.
I think that the Walker lean in, but I'm sure it was said kindly.
Going Jimmy Burr.
No, you're not.
Jimmy's not one to listen. Unless you're respectful.
PJ had an interesting way of disguising that respect then. Offensive foul, Bobby Martin with the elbow on Jerry Walker.
Well, Michael,
little acting there.
This is a call because you've been around a little bit and you know how to chat with officials. It was not number four, and it wasn't Jimmy Burr. Just the begging earlier on Karnishimus set that baby up.
Morning Star in to Mark. Haven wants to go on Morningstar this time. In and out with the turnaround. Walker, big time rebound.
Just out-wrestled them.
Out-wrestled Shorter.
Well, so much for those hooks.
Not many people do that. Over the top, Avan. Oh.
Bad play, bad call. And the reason it's a bad call is Shorter was beating baseline. He kept moving towards the baseline. It negates good defensive teaching. The seal, he gets both guys now. Here's the, that's where the call is, but Shorter's spacing out towards the baseline. You're supposed to call that one.
Morningstar, the 360 doesn't go down. A slow 360, but a 360 nonetheless.
Well, he made no time, but Avent should be able to do some. Now they switch it. They got Morningstar on Walker.
The hair, double pump, no. Again, Walker big on the offensive board.
Barrett did not body check. Watch. You've got to get after Walker. Very active guy.
Second on Morningstar, fifth on the team with 14:28 to go in the game. Walker will be at the line for two.
Walker, two shots.
Help a dick. All the basketball these young people have played, both pretty active along the sideline. Paul more subdued this year.
Yes, well, he is.
Better threads, have to take care of them. BJ with the sweater look. Very preppy.
Walker makes them both. The Hall back up by one. It's about the fifth or sixth lead change we've had here in the second half. Jason Matthews. Shorter this time, takes it from Walker and gets two.
Retaliation, retribution.
First two in the second half for Brian Shorter.
I think it might be Walker down there. Is it?
No, it's Avan.
That's right. I see Jerry on the side.
You need help?
And Brian Haber just pointed to the eye as the trainer is headed out along with PJ Carlissimo.
We talked about the flailing earlier. There is an awful lot of physical play and activity. That's the kind of Shorter play that you're used to. Have to take them out, I believe, so they don't get charged with the timeout.
Kanishevis will come in for Avan.
John Levitt out there to check him out, but here's the play. With the hand.
Yep, got a hand.
John Levitt's been a busy guy taking care of all the ills for B.J. Carlissimo.
Walker looking and finding Oliver Taylor, who just kind of brushes aside Jason Matthews.
Two men, Walker and Shorter, right? See it up.
And Walker's yelling, I got him. Just get the ball here.
Jerry, let's use a little sense. There's the switch they wanted. Good recovery.
Taylor tried to force it up, got the foul from Miller. Taken very many pretty shots tonight, but he's been effective.
Well, I guess he's forcing the issue on occasion is what you're driving at. But Anthony back in. Avan. Two tough post-up players now with Walker and Avan down low. So I would choose Morningstar's side only because of the quickness versus him. And he has a tendency to grab somebody if they have an angle on him.
For Oliver Taylor, seven coming in the second half.
And somebody explained to Terry that I'm not the official scorer. Because they're not useful, the TV being on this side. Usually facing the benches.
We do get some earfuls here, don't we?
Mm-hmm.
Seton Hall, a very, very good team at the free throw line. It's paid off for him so far tonight. 53-52, the Hall by one. 13:47 to go in the game.
Key time now for Pitt. Darrell Porter, the point guy. When they reset, it's imperative that that's where they have some problems when Sean Miller's out of the game.
Good spin move there by Porter, and he hits the baseline jumper.
Well, you don't have to reset when you can score like that.
He's got eight, Pitt by one. Getting to the ball. Walker tracks it down, but throws it away.
All because of a bad post entry pass. Too high and wide for Anthony.
Seton Hall has just had some critical turnovers.
Not a lot of them, but at tough times.
A little lost pass for Matthews.
When I say reset, Mike, if the first initial thrust of the offense doesn't work, you've got to reorganize. And that's something that Porter is not thoroughly used to doing.
Matthews, a runner partially blocked, and DeHare comes down with it. Gets it up to Cable.
Drive down, try and reverse it. They got him.
Winchester looks inside, but that's the first look. Everybody who gets the ball, Cable. Here it goes into Avent. He gets doubled. He goes anyway. Puck won't go. Jones is there.
He's had some tough shots go in and out.
Darrell. Matthews.
And a good knock call. Penetration. And of course, the setup man, Matthews. Well, welcome back to Pitt basketball for Jason.
Hit by four.
Had a weekend off.
5 points for Matthews all here in the second half.
Now here's execution. Pitt knows his play inside now. Here's a little double. First time today.
DeHare answers with three of his own.
Heck of a call. They have been running their normal UCLA stuff. And pulled the double.
Inside, shorter position, and decided to take the contact and get the foul, and he got it off Avent, his fourth.
Well, you're not raised in Philly looking to just get an easy douche. You want to have some bodies touching you. Brian Shorter loves the contact.
Avent and Martin, the two players with four. And Brian Shorter will go to the free throw line. 14 of Brian Shorter's 16 came in the first half with 11:49 to go in the game. Brian is actually scoring more per minutes played than he did last year when he averaged about 21 a game. It's just that whole minutes played thing.
Mm-hmm.
And again, in Brian's case, that viral infection that knocked him out for a long time really has caused him to come into the month of February still really not 100%, although a lot closer to it now than he was earlier.
Well, talking to Paul, he really made some changes because the defense has been his problem of late, giving up 50% field goal shooting to the opponent when he's been holding people to around 44%.
Inside, Walker leans in, blocking foul, Morningstar.
Excellent anticipation by Darren as he got over. Inability to finish cost you basketball games. Walker with a chance for three. It's tantalizing.
17 foul on Pitt, so Seton Hall will be shooting the rest of the way. 14 fouls on the Hall as Karnishevas comes back in, and DJ will try to buy a few minutes here for Anthony Avent, who sits down with four fouls.
Both coaches proponent of inside strength and going to it.
Bobby Martin sitting with four on the Pittsburgh bench. Walker, a sophomore out of that great program, St. Anthony's High School in New Jersey. And he makes the second. Five for Walker, all here in the second half. It's Pitt by one, 58-57, 11:36 to go.
There's a new kind of cowboy out there, and that's why McDonald's is grilling up a whole new kind of steak. McDonald's new grilled steak sandwich. And right now, it's a great McDonald's value you can't pass up.
Who guarantees overnight air delivery before 10:30 to the most places across the country?
you think?
Why do women always know when you're not telling them the whole story? And why do they always change plans at the last minute? And why do we keep putting up with them?
Why ask why? Try Bud Dry. It's cold filtered for smooth draft taste and dry brewed for no aftertaste. So while women may remain a mystery, refreshment won't.
Seems to me a new car warranty should cover the entire car for many miles. Now take Ford Taurus. Its basic warranty ends at just 12,000 miles. But the basic warranty on the new Cutlass Supreme goes a bit farther. Like from New York to L.A. Back to New York to L.A. To New York to L.A. New York to L.A. New York to L.A. New York to L.A. To New York. Plus a trip to Anchorage, Alaska. Cutlass Supreme with its bumper-to-bumper plus warranty. Here's one car that does it all and does it right. Hey, Dad.
This is the new generation of old.
Mike Gorman, go Raftery here at the Fitzgerald Fieldhouse on the campus of the University of Pittsburgh, and the Panthers have themselves a one-point lead, 58-57. First of three here on a big Monday on ESPN. Avin, the big night so far, 16-6, but he's got four fouls. Pittsburgh led by Shorter as usual. He's got 70.
And Shorter with those numbers keeps Chris McNeil on the bench,
where he has spent the entire evening.
Good-looking player, little zone look once more. 1-3-1, and Pitt got an easy basket when they used it the first half. Paul Evans thought somebody threw it at him.
That was a great reaction by Paul.
Now he's taking his seat wisely. Now in the back of the zone, you have Oliver Taylor. And the problem with that is any loop, he's got a problem, or any rebound. Cover both corners. They drop the big guys in the middle.
Matthews for three.
And he didn't get out quick enough.
Winchester stuffed by Shorter on the other end. Winchester got back in it for Porter, the loose ball.
Great reaction.
The Pitt crowd alive. Matthews jumper this time. Shorter, the offensive board. Morningstar, another rebound pulled down by Avin.
Expecting the bump, wasn't he? So recoil, thinking he'd get fouled. That's a great block, Mike.
Sure was. Woo. The Pitt crowd now calling for defense. Big trip here for the Hall. DeHare comes up shooting. Misses the three. Jones the rebound.
Man-to-man. The switch from the 1-3-1.
Jones, they leave him open.
What happened is Winchester did not recognize the switch of the defense.
DJ Carlissimo about 3 feet on the court to call the play.
Why not use Anthony Avin?
That was the plan, but it was picked off on a hustle play by Morningstar. Jones. Oh, and the block is called.
PJ upset because he's got him. They ran a play, they shot a jumper, they got Anthony down on the box, and of course the other end, the step in late.
Plus, Antoine Jones committed to that move about 25 feet from the basket.
He
look
made at his mind up at halftime.
Yes.
Ferry had just stood there and gotten settled. As Antoine had his mind made up.
He took off from the three-point line. Struggles a bit at the strike. Ferries out. Biggest lead of the half belongs to Pitt. It's five with 9:54 to go in the game. Looked pretty smooth on those two. Avin doesn't want it that far from the hoop.
Nice little powers.
Anthony spins too hard off the glass again, and Matthews the rebound.
Power cut. They got the alley-oop.
Nice catch by Shorter. Oliver Taylor just beat Porter to the ball. You don't see that much. A follow by DeHare won't count, but Oliver Taylor will go to the line.
Organization, so much to be said for it. Even Shorter took the alley-oop away from Antoine Jones. That was his. And then not having the composure to reset. Again, that ability to have the head. Now, they've made a nice run with the backcourt of Jason Matthews and Darrell Porter. But organization at critical times, particularly then, showed.
And Paul Evans has fished in that backcourt tonight. Has he tried to put combinations together?
Sharif to begin with Miller. Terrific inside screen there. They put the hair on the box and Anthony Aben makes the move for the goal, but a little bit harsh with that delivery.
Taylor, a 94% free throw shooter in conference game, buries two. Jones tracks down the Aaron Fowles. South Barnea is in the game for the Hall. Matthews with time. Good ball to Aven. Big for the rebound.
His shot. Shorter might be getting a blow, Mike. A long time ago.
Taylor rubbed off on a little pick. Can't hit the jump shot. Aven big for the offensive board. Wants to go up. Too hard again. Barnea kept it alive. Aven got grabbed from behind by Porter.
Heads up play by Darrell, too. Good spirit. Acknowledging Anthony in better position, but saved the basket for his club.
And Darrell Porter picked up his fourth personal foul on that. And Chris McNeil, who we had mentioned, now checks into the game.
Good pull right now. Plenty of time. Get a blow. Ready for stretch time.
Yo, guys. It'll be Avent at the free throw line. Avent and DeHare with the big first halves combined for 27 points have just five between the two of them in the second. Oliver Taylor has been the man along with Jerry Walker. Nick Crowley doing some housekeeping.
Right, might as well do it here, huh?
I'm told he doesn't do it at home.
He's not home enough.
Impressive numbers for Anthony Avent tonight. Still a long way to go, 8:47.
He's had some shots that just weren't soft enough. Put about four or five more baskets.
Ryan Shorter looks on.
The bigger the chest, the more impressive that American flag looks.
Having a clinic.
They give the defense the choice.
Mickey Crowley says, that's it. This is, stay where you are. And Sean Miller comes in for Porter, and that messes everything up, and Miller steps into the spot.
And that Sean will want another spot on the line. Now, with Sean in, you'll see the ball go lower. More often.
Aven able to keep his concentration through all of it. 63-61. Pitt the lead in the ball. Barnea out on Jones. Morningstar.
McNeil, as you mentioned, in the game, very tough. Jump shooter and down on the box. In the high pick and roll. And another one.
Fifteen on the shot clock. Matthews straightens up and misses. Follow Jones, no. Loose Morningstar.
Staying in position. That's the bag he permitted. You really must move guys out from underneath the 10.
He cleared a little space for himself before he took that shot.
Good use of the body.
DeHare can't answer with the three. Boy, a ton of shots have gone down and come out for Seton Hall tonight. Hit a chance to go up six.
Now here's the reset, Mike. They'll make sure they know exactly what they want done.
McNeil the screen.
Nice hedge.
Back to McNeil. Takes the shot. That's short. Walker the rebound. DJ Carlissimo quickly to call the play.
It's going to go to Anthony. How's that for a second?
Yeah, the dip in. Yeah, that's a good call.
Goes on Morningstar. Comes back the other way. Kicks it to the head. Gets it back again. Very nice entry pass that time, but it still won't go down for Avon.
Well, that's understanding the game. The hair. Well, right back at the guy. Defense goes down to help out on Anthony as they come back to you with the basketball. Terry DeHair acknowledging beautifully.
Morningstar picks up his fourth as Winchester comes in and Barnea sits down.
A ton of incomplete sequences by C.J. In and outs and good shots. I can't recall a bad one.
Nope. Well, Hall's going to get the chances here, though, as Pittsburgh has now committed their 10th team foul, so all fouls now are two shots for a very good free throw shooting team.
Now, Paul Evans, good job of resting guys too, so he's got some choices in Bobby Martin's foul problems to play in the last 7 minutes.
Morningstar, Martin, and Porter all with four fouls. Avent missing the second. Avent playing with four for Seton Hall. 65-62, Pitt. Miller likes what he sees. Takes it himself and draws a foul.
Wants the two-shot foul, I think he'll get it. That was a play designed for Jason Matthews, a double, and they just couldn't get it organized.
First on Oliver Taylor, sixth on the team. Barnea back in. And Anthony Avent comes out as we look at the all-time free throw leaders in the Big East and two of them in the Pitt backcourt, Jason Matthews and Sean Miller. Some pretty impressive names right below him. Mullen, Barrows, and George.
The other three are playing all over the country. Busy. A lot of mileage plus.
Darryl Christ is going to get his first minutes here as Miller rolls them both in. He's got seven. The lead is five. 6:55 to go in the game. 67 for Pitt, 62 for Seton Hall.
So you've been with your bank, what, 5, 10 years? They ever do anything special for you?
Please.
North Star does with a North Star One account.
Now that renews my faith in banks. Well, one, anyway.
And does your bank give you a personal banker?
A personal banker.
North Star does. You get one with a North Star One account.
A personal banker. Moi?
These days, you can buy a low-priced cellular phone almost anywhere. But down the road, will they be there when you need support like warranty service, routine maintenance, or answers on cellular service? 9X will. 9X Cellular Centers will help you at every turn, even if you didn't buy from us. Don't go it alone. Go with the experts. For mobile communications, the answer is 9X.
Tuesday night, it's a live NCAA basketball doubleheader. First, highly ranked Oklahoma takes on Kansas State. Then, unbelievable Shaquille O'Neal leads LSU against Kentucky. Live Tuesday night on ESPN. Thursday night, top shooter Oliver Miller leads Arkansas against Houston. Then the dynamic duo of Christian Laettner and Bobby Hurley guides Duke against Virginia. An NCAA basketball doubleheader, Thursday night, live on ESPN.
Mike Gorman from Aftree back here at Fitzgerald Fieldhouse, 67-62, Pitt by five, 6:55 to go, and Big Monday will roll on. Northwestern will take on Illinois, and then at midnight, Loyola Marymount and Cal Santa Barbara will run up and down the floor for about 2.5 hours.
And nobody works harder than Bill Foster. It's just tough. We've got a lot of young players at Northwestern.
Walker fakes the down and out and gets it into the hair. Darryl Christ seeing his first minutes, and they're big ones. He's got Miller on him defensively.
Now, BJ doing the same thing now to get a little blow for Oliver Taylor for stretch time.
DeHair calls the play.
Sort of a Walker kind of an offense right now for DeHair.
Barnea was calling for an inside, looking for Walker. Can't make the pass, gives it up to DeHair.
DeHair's pretty good with his entry passes.
Ten on the shot clock.
Better come up with something here, guys. First finds DeHair. Quick three. Well short and picked off by Shorter underneath.
Offensively, not enough guys looking at the goal. Asafi, Barnea, and of course, Gordon Winchester. The only guy was Walker.
Matthews buries a three outside. Big bucket right there. 11 for Matthews, all in the second half. DeHair looks to answer. No. Rebound. Porter.
Two tough trips for the Hawk.
Durrell. No look pass. McNeil. Got it baseline.
Well, he missed the first one, but was ready for that.
5:26 to go, and Pitt has their biggest lead of the game. It's 10.
Of all these cold medicines, only one combines the pain reliever in Advil with the medicine in Sudafed. Coadvil. Last year, 7 million people discovered it.
It was a sinus as well as a head cold.
Lead weights in my face all through here. It felt like a clogged drain.
Coadvil just cleared everything up.
It was like the lead weights had just gone away.
I was not drowsy with Coadvil at all.
Try Coadvil, and the next cold won't seem so bad.
Coadvil, advanced formula for cold and sinus relief.
Our projection screen looks so real, you'll feel like part of the show when you watch the new RCA Home Theater. It also has surround sound that's so real.
Stand back, everyone.
You'll forget you're sitting at home.
Let me handle this.
The RCA Home Theater also has Picks and Picks. It lets you watch two things at once in color. Another way, RCA is changing entertainment again.
Chris Kelly knows a little beachfront hotel where the view is breathtaking, but the prices aren't. Now, where do you suppose she'd rent a car? Budget. Where she can reserve a car that's less than 6 months old in less than 3 minutes for a very relaxing price. The smart money is on budget.
Now you can rent a Lincoln for the smart rate of $99 for any 3 days with unlimited mileage at any participating budget location. The smart money is on budget.
26 to go in what has suddenly become a 10-point game, 72-62. Timeout, Seton Hall with just one left, Pitt three. Pitt already over the limit, but they have the possession arrow. More importantly, they got the 10-point lead. Walker's having some trouble getting it in, too. Finally, Taylor comes to it. Big possession here for the Hall.
Sure is. Inside when you need, you got to get to the foul line. Pitt doing a nice job of keeping everything on one side so they can't reverse and dump it down.
Winchester looking for Avan. DeHair comes to the ball. Walker wants it on McNeil. Turns and faces. Goes up and gets two.
Now they need something out of their defense. I was going to say, Shorty did a great job on Anthony Avan on the other box.
Ways Matthews through, pops back out.
Use the weave, and they use the big guy to do a pick on occasion. Saw McNeil trying to set one up. Good call right here. Shorty just extended the arm and pushed all the way up to the foul line. All he had to do was hold and have the dribbler bring it down. Darrell Porter
gives the Hall a chance to score some points without any time going off the clock. 4:36 to go. Jerry Walker at the free throw line. He has 7 points all here in the second half.
I think Seton Hall can get free throws by getting to the box. I don't think you have any problem on this end. It's the far end, the defensive end. Of course, PJ tried to sneak a minute or two with some subs and in effect realized he didn't have the offense he wanted on the floor, but you've got to play for the end of the game because all of these games seem to end up puzzle games.
Walker 1-2. 72-65. It's 7 now.
Zone up by Anthony down low. You might get McNeil for jumper if they are patient.
Miller looked for shorter, but really got upset when he didn't get the ball. Porter pops out inside to Bryan. Tough getting the handle. Back to Miller. Nearly stolen by Taylor. 20 on the shot clock. Darrell Porter. McNeil outside. You didn't like that shot, Coach, huh?
Well, I didn't even get one, but I thought it'd be in the forward spot.
The hair spots up. Hits a three. Whoa, that's a big swing. 72-68, six straight for the Hall after being down 10. 3:47 to go.
Now you want your money guy. You got to run something to get it to shorter.
Porter pops out. Shorter trying to hold off Walker. McNeil. Second shot.
Look at this.
Bryan goes up and gets it, and a foul is on Jerry Walker.
Michael, he shed everybody. Those big shoulders extending. A physical presence. Oh, my goodness.
Martin comes back in for McNeil.
You say to your guys, you know, check down, keep the guy off the glass, and just a quicker, stronger, and able to get to the free throw line. I believe it's 1-1 as we hit the seventh. That's why he was banging the ball. I wish he had gotten the shot off in our replay.
18 for short, four here in the second half.
One long is just up front to one of the officials. Everybody looking for an inch.
Taylor finds Walker. Even trying to free himself. Martin's got him underneath.
Got him.
Go over the top. Anthony powers it up and gets it.
No help. Had emptied the backside. And Martin with the front looking for help.
21 for Anthony Avent, the game's high scorer. Hit by four as we crack the three-minute mark. Winchester, Porter, great spin around him. Gives to Martin, lost it on the way up, but gets the benefit of a foul.
I think it might be Winchester. Power, basketball.
Third foul on Gordon Winchester.
There'll be arms grappling on each attempt.
That loud voice you may hear in the background belongs to PJ Carlissimo, asking the officials not to anticipate.
I thought he might be offering up a novena for him. Hurt his hand, and Mickey Crowley, having been around, just lets him rest a little. Bobby Martin on the foul line.
Gets the roll. Eight for Mark. The lead is five. Gets them both.
Wrapping it off.
76-70.
See, they're running some quick hitters right now.
The hair partially blocked.
And after, now this should be after, but with the 10 fouls,
it's going to be a three-shot foul.
Well, they are giving him the three.
Yeah, they are.
Mm.
Jason Matthews picking up the foul. Terry DeHaer goes to the line for three.
Well, you want to challenge closeout with balance. Put a wrinkle in that DB.
I haven't seen this call as much as I thought it would when the rule went through. And you can almost count on one or two hands the number of times you see it over the course of the year.
I think it's because you prepare with drills to go out and challenge the guy under control. I agree with you. I thought a lot of guys would be sprinting out challenging.
20th point for DeHaer. More importantly, gets Seton Hall within five.
But DeHaer has that ability to attract bodies on his shot, too.
Oh, missed two out of three. An 85% free throw shooter.
The back screen had this 2-1-2 set from the foul line to free people. See Miller on Porter? Then they'll end up running.
DeHaan, the steal on Matthews. Gets the layup this time. Made sure of it.
In the open floor, you can't give it up. You must play tough with the basketball out there.
And Pitt is going to take a timeout. At the 2-minute mark exactly, it's 76-73. Pitt by three. We'll be back.
Fun cartoon character in a hot new 16-bit game.
Genesis does.
Who does Disney animation as only a 16-bit video game can?
Genesis
does.
Genesis
does.
Genesis
does.
Genesis
does.
Genesis does.
Who gives you $30 cash back when you buy a new Sega Genesis system?
Genesis does.
Buy a Sega Genesis system now and get $30 cash back.
Michael, Paul Evans went to a 2-1-2 delay game just to run some clock. And you can do that when you've got good free throw shooters. But this time, Jason Matthews asleep, not warding off. A very active Terry DeHaan. I would look for them to come back and get right into their action because of that turnover and the ability that they've had to get it in low, particularly to Mr. Schroeder.
You know, Bill, how often do you see DeHaan miss two or three free throws? You knew he was going to try to make, quote, the play.
He does.
You know, and he did. But,
an action guy. The out of this, out of bounds, they occasionally, they won't look for an alley-oop, but they will on occasion go for it.
DJ did not like the defensive alignment on the inbounds pass. Gordon Winchester will be reminded of that when he watches the films.
3-2 now, a little different look.
16-15 on the shot clock.
You want to stay at home and everybody guard their own guy. You don't want to gamble and turn it into a layup.
Got to get into something here. Porter takes it strong. Count the bucket. Score the bucket and the foul. Wow. With three on the shot clock.
Well, you can talk about youthful performances, but a vet only has the intestinal fortitude to pry out there with the clock running down, to penetrate, and the motion was there. Good call, and Darrell Porter, not only a fine player here, but one of the more popular in the Big East. Gutsy, gutsy play.
11 points, 9 assists for Darrell Porter on the night.
Going with some size now with Jones in. And Porter, they yo-yo because of that knee.
The lead is 6.
Need the quick hitter. Screen down. Look for Anthony or DeHaan.
DeHaan takes it in, trying to get the contact. Got the contact, but not the ball. Avent reaches, gets it. And you're going to get a goaltend, maybe?
No, I think it's Bobby Martin with the reach in. They are going after it, though. Above and beyond defensively.
Fifth foul on Bobby Martin. Porter comes back in. Jones goes out. Brian Haver will check in. And Gordon Winchester will go out. And Anthony Avent takes his 21 points to the free throw line.
Avent in the foul line.
1:15 to go.
Excuse me, Mike. Hasn't been as much a factor late because DeHaan has started to light it up and get the proper bucks.
Two two for Avent. 5-point game. Before the clock even went off, as he grabbed a hold of Sean Miller.
Well, 115, if we're going to give it, why wait for the shot clock to start?
That's the guy you want to give it to, though.
No, not too many people with fouls this backcourt. I don't think he intentionally did it, though, Mike.
They're
trying to prevent him for the inbounds pass.
Seton Hall now over the limit, so all fouls are two. We're back to the bench as PJ makes offensive and defensive substitutions. 115 to go, 79-75, 80-75.
And Caber will get his shot. He's a good-looking performer.
Sean Miller gives that ball every chance to go in the way he throws it up there.
Fingertips around it, huh? And look at that.
Oh,
Walker in traffic, couldn't squeeze it.
What a break for Pitt.
And normally, they're looking for Matthews as he inbounds and then screening for him, but this will be a case of getting it in and then trying to run a little bit.
About a shorter. Out to Miller. Winchester the foul under Al Porter with 1:02 to play.
PJ signaling to give it up. Don't let it run down on him.
You got Trey 3 for 7 now.
Oh, yeah.
And Porter will step to the line for two.
Both the hair and Taylor can nail them at good numbers. Taylor at 46% from three.
Pitt's making them, but they're rolling them in.
Mm-hmm. Think of his big three-point play earlier.
Yes. Porter goes out. Antoine Jones comes in. It's a 7-point game. 1:02 to go. Here comes Oliver Taylor. Winchester.
Nice
find to hair. He is wide open and he makes it for three. I want to try to get Miller to make a pass.
The next guy. Trying to keep it away from their big guys.
That's the guy I think they want to get, and they didn't get to him in time. They wanted to foul Antoine Jones. Walker picks up his fourth foul. The one's rather inconsequential right now as Kanishevich is going to check back in.
Good ball when you think of adding another three-plus size, three-point shooter, that is, plus the size that Artemis brings.
Jerry Walker thought he was going to the bench, but no, it'll be Gordon Winchester. PJ trying to find out why Gordon didn't foul Antoine Jones.
He tried. Two possession game, so you can let the rush for the three.
You got to rush a little, only 34 seconds
to go. You push it, but you can settle, go for yeah. Two on this trick.
It's a 5-point game, 20 for shorter.
A lot of size on the floor for an offensive rebound, too.
Kanishevich pops out, looking for DeHair, puts it on the floor himself. Finds DeHair, comes up shooting. Not this time, big rebound by shorter. And Walker fouls it. So we will walk the other way and shoot some free throws with 17 seconds to go. Pitt by 5, 83-78. Looking to go 5-4 in the conference. And looking to push Seton Hall under the 500 mark at 5-6.
three-point game. Write a script on these games.
At least for this conference.
Push, shoot quick. Got one to play with.
Makes it a three-possession game now with that free throw. Taylor takes it in and gets two and calls a quick timeout. 9 seconds to go, 85-80. DJ Carlissimo, not happy.
Well, that spurt to 10 caught them. And then you think of the three free throws in a row by Terry DeHare making one. And all of a sudden they had themselves in some difficulty.
Yeah.
But Pitt and this really awfully tough to compete with.
Let's take a look at the standings now, and you figure the Hall will go to 5-6, barring a miracle here, down 5 with 9 seconds to go, and Pittsburgh to 5-4. Syracuse and St. John's up there at 7-3. St. John's will meet Villanova tomorrow night at Madison Square Garden. And Georgetown here on ESPN later this week will play Providence. And if you haven't caught Eric Murdoch's yet, check that out.
And a bounce-back game for Georgetown, too.
Yes. Surprising loss there yesterday. Northwestern and Illinois are coming up next. Bob Carpenter and Nick Vitale. How did I forget?
Oh,
Nick Vitale.
How did that slip?
I'll hear about that, I'm afraid.
That's what a great foul shooting backcourt does, though. They really cost you time when you're trying to make sure others touch it. You're almost caught giving it to either Miller or Matthews.
Garnishev is all over the inbounds pass. Porter throws it into Matthews, who just kind of bear hugs it with 8 seconds to go. Paul Evans yelling at his own timekeeper here, saying, how could only 1 second go off? But that's all it did. It's 8 seconds to go, 85-80. The crowd feels this one is over. Stranger things have happened. Jason Matthews and Sean Miller, the two in the backcourt, and you couldn't ask for two better free-throw shooters.
Well, we think of Pitt bouncing back. As Paul mentioned, we got clobbered. We were terrible. See if they go to half-court or at least the quick push. Yep, they go up to half. They got to take the quickie.
DeHare will have to put it up. He does. Can't get it down. Ball saved by Porter. And that is going to do it. As the Pittsburgh Panthers win at home here at Fitzgerald Fieldhouse, 86-80 over Seton Hall. Final thought.
Good, strong second half. I thought the backcourt played well. I thought the biggest play was Darrell Porter's three-pointer. But typical of this conference, the way they end. Make the free throws, you got a chance to seal it.
One that Paul Evans really needed in this town of Pittsburgh. That'll take some of the heat off his program. 86-80, the final score for Bill Raftery. This is Mike Gorman sending it back to John Saunders.
Thanks a lot, Mike and Bill. 6-point victory for the Pitt Panthers, so they end a three-game losing streak. Seton Hall, on the other hand, they now have a three-game losing streak. Jim Valvano, as you looked at this game, we talked about the fact that they were pounding down underneath. It would take something else to win the game.
And it did. We had both Matthews taking the outside shot and hitting it, and Porter with the drive, three-point play. The little guys won this one the second half.
All right, stay with us. There's more to come. It's Big Monday on ESPN's NCAA basketball. Still two more games to come. Once again, the final score, the Pitt Panthers, the winner by 6. And coming up next, we'll move to the Big Ten, Northwestern and Illinois.
You can teach your kids the fun of basketball.